गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? ओके, वेरी गुड. तो इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टार्टेड द ज्योमेट्री पार्ट, दैट इज द एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स. एंड इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैड एक्सप्लेन्ड यू दैट द एरिया ऑफ जनरल फॉर्मूला ऑफ एरिया ऑफ ट्रायंगल इज हाफ इंटू बेस इंटू हाइट. सो इफ दिस इज द बेस एंड दिस इज द हाइट in a triangle, any triangle, then its general formula of area of triangle is half base into height. But the general formula of the triangle, area of a triangle, is equal to half into base into height. But in some cases when the height will not be given, in the question, only the three sides will be given in a triangle, then in those cases one alternative method is there, that is called the Heron's formula. And by using Heron's formula, we can find the area of the triangle if all the three sides will be given. Suppose height is not given, so by using the Heron's formula, if three sides will be given only, then we can find its area. So that is the, that's why we need the Heron's formula, because in some cases where the height will not be given, only the three sides will be given, how can we find the area of the triangle? And in those cases we will use the Heron's formula. So come, what is that Heron's formula? The Heron's formula says that, first I am writing the formula, then I will explain you the terms used in it. The area of triangle by using Heron's formula, that is root over S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. This is the formula. Then let me explain what is the meaning of all these terms. S means that is called semi-perimeter. So S means semi-perimeter. Semi-perimeter means the half of the perimeter, means perimeter by two. By adding all the sides, we can find the perimeter, and divided by 2, that is the semi-perimeter. And A, B, C are the three sides of the triangle. So A, B, C value, it may be anything. It may be numerical value, its numerical value may be anything. But it is, I am taking here, it is A, means any one length of the side, it is B and it is C. So semi-perimeter means that is equal to A plus B plus C by 2. That means the sum of all sides of the triangle divided by 2, that is called the semi-perimeter. Now I am just taking one example. By that example I will explain you how we will apply the Heron's formula in a triangle. This here ABC, instead of taking ABC, I am taking three different values, that is three different values, just a minute, three different values I am taking, three different values I am taking, 32 meter, 24 meter and 40 meter. Suppose it is 32 meter, it is 40, it is 32 meter, it is 24 and 40, it is 24 meter and it is 40 meter. One question may be formed like this, that a triangular plot having the sides 32 meter, 24 meter and 40 meter, then what will be its area? A triangular plot has three sides, which is given in the figure, that is 24 meter, 32 meter and 40 meter, then it is asked to find the area. Obviously we will use the Heron's formula here, because here height is not given, suppose height will be given, then we can find half base into height, but height is not given. So definitely we will use the Heron's formula. So by using Heron's formula, the same formula we will use here, that is area will be equal to root over S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Remember one thing, whenever you will do any problems, any sum, then you have to write what formula you are using. What, because one mark is there, what formula a child is using, that should be written first. Then after you will put the values of that, of the things, what are the given things will be there, then you will put the value. So here we will find the semi perimeter. The semi perimeter is equal to this plus this plus this divided by 2. So it is 32 plus 24 plus 40 divided by 2, or that is equal to 96 by 2, or that is equal to 48 meter. So semi perimeter value we got, that is 48 meter. Now directly we will apply the formula there. So area is equal to root over S. S means already we have found out, that is 48 meter. So 48 into S minus A. Any side you can take A. Suppose I am taking, this is the my A. This is my A, this is my B, this is my C. So 48 minus 32. 48 minus 32. Then again 48 minus 24. Then again 48 minus 40. So these are the three values. Now that is equal to, again it is 48 minus 32, that is equal to 16. 48 minus 24, that is equal to 24. 48 minus 40, that is equal to 8. Now here what you will do to find the root over, square root, no need to multiply. And actually generally students, what they do, they do the multiplication, means they multiply all the things, then what the bigger value they get, then they take the square root. No, that is not the way. This is the way. Here you see, here my 148, so I can write it is 48, I can write it is 24 into 2. Why I took 24? Because 124 is already there with me. So that's why I split the 48 into 24 into 2. Then 16, I can take it 8 into 2. 4 into 4 also 16, but I took 8 into 2 because 18 is already present with me. So it is 8 into. Then this 24 I kept like that, and this 8 I kept like that. Now that is equal to, you see, out of a pair, it is 24, it is 24. I am taking the square root, means you just bring 124 out into. This is 8, this is 8. So from this pair I am bringing another 8 out. Then this 2 and this 2, I am taking another 2. So this is equal to, it is equal to, 24 into 2, that is equal to 48. 48 into 8, that is equal to 384 meter. Am I right? No, I am not right. Why? Because the area should be always in square units. Here it is meter, that should be meter square. That should be meter square. So this is the area of the square. By using the Huron's formula, I found it here. Then another, similarly we can take another example. There is a triangle, it is example 2 I am taking. Complete it. Write quickly. This question number 2. Here one triangle is given and two sides are given. One triangle is given and two sides are given, centimeter. And also it is given, the perimeter is 32 centimeter. Perimeter is given. So perimeter is given 32 centimeter. So we can find the remaining this side. So it is 11 plus 8, that is equal to, perimeter means sum of all the sides. So it is 11 plus 8, that is equal to 19 centimeter. So this side will be 32 minus 19, that is equal to 13 centimeter. Yes. So now it is asked, what is its area? This area it is asked to find out. Similarly, same formula, root over S into S minus A into S minus U into S minus C. But here S value will be changed because it is another problem. Question number 2, another example. So here S will be this plus this plus this divided by 2. or directly perimeter is given in the question. So no need to add and no need to find once again. So it is 32 by perimeter. Perimeter ka aadha hai. Half of the perimeter is called the semi-perimeter. So it is 32 by 2, that is equal to 16 centimeter. Now the formula. Now we put here area. Area is equal to S. Already we got the value of X, that is equal to 16 into S minus A. Once again, I am not writing means from the beginning. Directly you just subtract it. 16 minus 8, directly I am writing 8. Then 16 minus 11, directly it is 5. 16 minus 13, directly it is 3. No need to write once again. So now this is equal to 16. 16 means it is 8 into 2. 8 is already 1, 8 is there. 5 is there, 3 is there. Now this is equal to, out of these 2, 8, I can bring 1, 8 out. And the remaining things, it is only a single one are there. So I cannot find it, means I cannot bring it out. Directly you multiply this into this, 2 into 5 into 3, that is equal to 30. So 8 root 30 centimeter. Suppose in question it is asked, you can keep your answer in this way. But suppose sometimes in question it is asked, give your answer in decimal form. Strictly it will be written in the class, written in the question, that you give your answer in decimal form. In that case, you have to find out the square root of 32. I hope you know how to find the square root. If you don't know, then see carefully here. So root of 32, we can find by division method. By division method, we can find the square root of any number. Suppose here it is 30. Now, take any number here, but the same number here. But their multiplication must be less than 30. So if I will take 6, here 6 means there 6, but 6 into 6, that is 36. It exceeds this value, so I cannot take it. Then you take 5. So it is your choice. You will choose what value you will take. So 5 into 5, that is equal to 25. Now you subtract, it is 5. Whatever the value you will take it here, same value you will add here. So 5 plus 5, that is equal to 10. Now, here it is a smaller number. Here it is a bigger number. I cannot divide it. So you will put the decimal point. So decimal point, if you will find the square root, and if a decimal point will be given, then directly double zero. In normal division, if the decimal point will be used, then a single zero will be given. But in case of square root, when you will find the square root, means single zero, it is by the state government, but double zero, it is the Modi government, right? So it is, if a double is, we are finding the square root here. So double zero will be given. Why double zero? Because we are finding square root of 30. So if double zero will be given, now you take any digit here, but the same digit here. Same digit here, same. So you think what you can take. I am thinking I can take, not, I cannot take 5. If I will take 5, then what I am getting? 5 with multiplication with all total. Remember, this 5 will be multiplied with all these, means 105. So it is becoming 525, which exceeds to 500. I cannot take it. So you take 4. So if you will take 4, then 4 into 4, 16, and 4 into 1, that is 416. So it is 84. Now, it is one stage over. Again, already decimal point is given means, जितना दूर तुम जाओगे, जितना काम करोगे, तुमको डबल जीरो ही मिलेगा, ओके? तो अगेन यू विल गेट डबल जीरो, अगेन यू विल गेट डबल जीरो, एंड व्हाटएवर द वैल्यू यू हैड टेकन हियर, द सेम वैल्यू ऐड हियर, मींस नाउ योर डिवाइजर इज 108 एंड योर डिविडेंड इज 8400. वंस अगेन यू सी व्हाट वैल्यू यू विल टेक. Directly I can say up to 7 I can take, not 7, it is 6 I hope 6 will be accurate. So 6 into 6, this 6, now you remember, this 6 will be multiplied with all total. So 6 into 6, that is 36. 6, I took 3. So I am getting 6516. Till now I am not sure whether I can take 7 or not. Try it. Because nobody can, you try it. If you will take 7, instead of 6, if you will take 7, what value you are getting? So 7 into 7, 49. Yes, I can take 7 also, because 7609, it is a less value also than 8400. So I can take 7 also. So previously I had take 6, now it I can take the maximum value, that is 7. So it is, it will be 7609, but I cannot take 8. Surely we cannot take 8. So it will be 7 here. So 7 into 7, 49, 9, 4, 7 into 8, 56, 56 plus 4, 60, I kept 0, 6, then 7 into 1, no, 7 into 0, that is, oh, what I, 7 into 7, yes, it is the correct one. Now you subtract. Yes, you see, it is 791. Definitely it is a less value to that one. So up to two decimal places you can find, so it is 5.47. So the square root of 30 we got, it is 5.47. But you cannot say that its value will be 5.47 unless you will go to the third step. This is the, these are the things already you have taught, I have taught you in standard 7 and 8. So it is, you can take this root 30 is equal to 5.47. So 8 into 5.47, you can get the value in cm square, and that's the area. Sometimes in question, just a minute, sometimes a question, it will be asked, means what will the, means it will be extra question will be extend that after finding the area, find the height to the longest side. Question can be extended that after finding the area, find what is the height to the longest side. So at that time you will compare, you will, because area will be same, whether you may use half base into height, whether you may use Heron's formula, but area definitely it will be same in all the cases. So at that time you will compare half into base into height, that is equal to this one. This one, whatever the value you will get. Suppose base is given in a triangle, then you can directly by cross multiply these two with this result, and this B by dividing the base, you can find the height. So you can find the height also. So like this, by using the Heron's formula, you can find the area, and by finding the area also you can find the height of a triangle also. So next class we will discuss the rest of the things, means some many more problems I will do in next class. For today's class this is over. Okay, thank you.